Hey, Internet, we watched Batman vs. Superman, so you don't have to. I'm really mad about watching it. It was not my idea.
I think everyone knows that most things are my idea at this point.
This was not as bad as Man of Steel.
No, it was not.
That I didn't feel bad.
I know. I felt terrible after we were done with Man of Steel. I did not feel that way, like, during or after this movie. It was not good.
No.
But it did not make me feel a crushing sense of despair in the same way that Man of Steel did.
Man of Steel is the worst movie I've ever seen. This is just...
Yeah, it might be.
This is just dumb.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't even have strong feelings about it.
Yeah, this is just, like, pretty standard shitty movie shitty.
It's...
You're so much taller than me. I'm having trouble keeping you in frame.
Better.
I just need to have better posture.
The whole... You know, normally I do that thing where I'm like, oh, this is how that could have been better. Oh, this... It's fucked. It's fucked from the first word.
Yeah.
It's a bad idea. It's a bad everything. It's a shitty execution of a shitty idea.
Yes.
With a shitty script. It has Amy Adams and Gal Gadot. That's all it's got going for it.
And Lawrence Fishburne.
And Lawrence Fishburne, yes.
As Perry Mason.
Wait. And Perry Mason had showed up. I was just... I'd have been fine with that. Like, it wouldn't have made anything worse.
Okay, well, first, we gotta get to the bottom of one very important thing, which is Batman a vampire?
Yes.
Okay, we got to the bottom of it.
But he was born a vampire. He is okay. From a vampire family because he is surrounded by bats... They yep. accept him as one of their own, and they lift him into the sky.
Yeah, this movie just starts out very strong with a hard turn into magical realism. I don't know that that was the correct choice, but it was a choice.
We get a weird flash forward where the combined forces of Superman and Apocalypse rule the Earth. No, that was clearly because it had okay. The flaming pyres, then it had the parademons, and that's dark side shit.
Okay, but, like, Apocalypse is Marvel, and...
Or not a...
And dark side is DC.
No, Apocalypse is the planet, and dark side is the planet.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, see, this is where, like, me knowing shit about DC Comics would come in handy, but I don't.
I'm 90... Look... There's using superlatives as names gets old with these.
Yep.
So yeah, the
is Apocalypse a superlative?
I don't know. Fuck it.
It doesn't matter. Like, this is like, it's not worth analyzing. This is really stupid.
But it's clearly trying to set up Darkseid as the villain for the Justice League movie. Everything about this movie is just setting up the Justice League movie.
Mm-hmm.
The actual fight between Batman and Superman takes place an hour and 45 minutes into this goddamn movie.
Yeah.
And it's like 20 minutes long.
Oh god, this movie is so long.
Like, the somehow...
fight scenes are so long.
Somehow that fight scene is so long, but it's also supposed to be what the whole movie is built around.
Yeah.
And it's 20 minutes of a 2.5 hour long movie.
Yeah.
Batman spends as much time doing, PX90 in the Batcave as he does fighting Superman. It's...
Chris stole my joke again.
Sorry. But he's literally... He's not even flipping a tire.
He's just hitting a tire with a hammer. Is that an accepted part of PX90?
Do I look like I would know?
I don't know how PX90 works.
Megan, how does PX90 work?
I have no idea.
If you hit a hammer, you're a healthcare professional. If you hit a hammer with a, if you hit a tire, hit a hammer with a tire.
Yeah, hit a hammer with a tire.
If you hit a tire with a hammer.
If you hit a hammer with a tire, you probably don't need P90X.
Probably not.
Like, but like, if you hit a tire with a hammer, does it make you stronger? Like, does that do a thing?
Yeah, it does a thing.
What's the thing it does? What's the health benefits of hitting a tire with a hammer?
Muscles or something.
Megan, explain Batman's power.
He's very rich. That's his power.
Sarah just nailed it.
Entitlement.
White privilege. I don't know why the drunk person was allowed to hold the selfie stick.
Do you want me to hold it?
I don't know. It's going to be better. You have very shaky hands.
I do. I do.
We're between a rock and a hard place here.
Let's both hold it and make it super shaky. It's like a Ouija board. I didn't move it. You moved it. Yeah, so the parademons show up, and that turns out to possibly be a dream sequence. But then he comes out of that dream sequence, and yeah. Then the Flash is there from the future?
I don't actually know that was the Flash. I'm starting to think that was Cyborg.
Well, someone from the future.
Somebody from the future who's going to be in a future movie.
I assume the Flash, because he's the time traveler.
It doesn't matter. Who cares?
But he goes, you were right about him! But then that's also a dream sequence. And yeah. Then he takes his top and he spins it. But we never see if it falls, so we don't know if he's in a dream sequence the whole time. We don't
know. There's no way to know.
There's no way to know. No.
It's a mystery that's lost to time.
Bomb! Like, that would not have made this movie any worse.
No.
There were multiple layered dream sequences.
Yeah. Well, there was just that one.
No, like, there was... Wasn't there another one?
I don't think so.
I don't remember.
I mean, like, this might be a thing, like, in Man of Steel, where I just immediately forgot things that happened.
There was the flying monkey thing. That was one dream.
Those are parademons.
And there was and the then, other one.
Yeah. There yeah, that's two. The that's the same one.
Wonder Woman is amazing.
Yes.
She is
40 movies about her. She's great.
She is radiant and gorgeous and fun. And she's like having a great time during that fight.
I want her to bench press me.
Yeah. Sarah's dream is just to find someone who will bench press her.
Not anybody, a pretty lady.
Yes. That part's obvious. Yes. I think that's well established by now.
I would hope so.
she's great. She's got the best theme song.
Yeah.
Like, she shows up, and it's like the...
her musical sting is real choice.
My wife is going to extreme lengths to make sure she is never at any part of this. She's
no,
dancing.
I'm about to cough. I'm trying not to ruin your video.
Thank you.
Well, now it's totally ruined.
The integrity of this has just collapsed.
We've parted the kimono. They've seen... They've seen too much. I think they know now that we just filmed this on a cell phone in my living room. Oh, God. The really tight editing probably confused people.
Yeah, we edit around everything so seamlessly. Oh, man. What else?
Nothing. There's what's to talk about? Jesse Eisenberg is making strong choices.
He is. He's
not
making
good choices.
Not good choices, but strong choices. Amy Adams continues to be wasted. I can't understand how you could cast Amy Adams as Lois Lane and then totally waste her for two entire movies.
I just want a movie with Lois Lane and White, just like a
Perry
movie
Mason.
About Perry Mason. Yeah, just like just do The Wire with those two. There's this really interesting like news drama going on.
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, every single character in this movie is off in a different movie. Like, Amy Adams is off like in The Pelican Brief, and I guess Superman is in The Wire. Batman's in he's in an infomercial for P90X. Oh, Jeremy Irons is really good in this movie.
Oh, yeah.
As Alfred. We like him. He's just like sassing Batfleck and complaining that Bruce is never going to give him any grandchildren.
They look the same age, was Alfred like an intern?
Yeah.
When Bruce's parents died?
Yeah, Alfred was just like Jeffrey Dean Morgan's teen ward, I guess. Oh, yeah, Jeffrey Dean Morgan plays Batman's dad for, like, 20 seconds.
Which because seems like, we have to see that again.
Yeah, which seems like a waste of your Jeffrey Dean Morgan.
We have to know that his parents were killed.
Although that's the theme of these movies, is that they hire really good actors and then they waste them. Like, I feel like the thing with the Christopher Nolan Batman movies was like, hey, what if we hire, like, good actors to be in our superhero movie? And then everybody's like, oh, cool. And then the Snyderverse Batman movies, it's like, hey, what if we hire good actors and then do nothing with them? That'd be cool, right? Nope.
Here's the thing. And here is why I have no sympathy for the panic that Warner Brothers is in. And they are panicked, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
Because of how badly received these last two movies have been.
Yup.
That said, Wonder Woman looks pretty cool.
Wonder Woman does look good. It's not directed by Zack Snyder, so that's probably a good sign.
And I kind of give a shit about Aquaman for the first time.
I know.
Because it's Khal Drogo.
That's super weird, but yeah.
He's just like an angry, drunk sailor.
I like this Namor Aquaman. I think it's well established at this point that I really love Namor the Submariner. I know you don't get it, but you don't have to get it. I love him. That's it.
No one gets it.
I love him.
Joe Quesada doesn't get it.
He's the worst. That's why he's great.
That explains a lot of your choices in life.
I know. You give me like a terrible trash character and I'm like, this is my son. Are you my son?
Yes. You finally found me.
I found you.
Let's not get into the weird temporal mechanics of that.
Yep.
I'm old. most of this movie is taken up setting up the Justice League movie.
Yes.
The subtitle is Dawn of Justice, in case you thought this was just going to be about Batman and Superman punching each other. There's a black scientist building cyborgs, so of course it's Joe Morton.
Yep.
Because Joe Morton plays every black scientist for the last 35 years?
Yes. There are no other black scientists.
Nope. Nope. It's all Joe Morton.
It's just him.
I love Joe Morton. Glad he's getting work. What else? This movie's dumb.
It's real dumb.
I just want to talk more about Wonder Woman. I have a lot of questions about, like, who's financing her.
Yeah, it's not clear where she's getting her money. She clearly has a lot of money. Did she just make, like, some really good investments in, like, 1918, and then she's just living off those dividends?
She stole the Kaiser's gold.
Did she? Although, like, you would have to take into account the crash of 29, so...
She caused the collapse of the Weimar Republic!
Oh, no! No, I was talking about, like, the stock market crash of 29. Like, she would have lost, presumably... a lot of money.
Unless she's holding gold, because the value of gold went up when the stock market crashed.
Is she psychic? Did she get her money out of the bank? It's not clear. She could be psychic.
Her mom's Athena, so she probably is pretty good at stock trading.
Her mom's not Athena.
Yeah.
Her mom's Hippolyta.
She's had so many origin stories.
She's made of clay.
Well, no, in that version, she was made by Zeus.
No, she's made of clay, and she was imbued...
The homunculi.
Her mom was Hippolyta, and Hippolyta made a baby out of clay. And when it was dry and ready, like, all of the female goddesses in Hermes imbued it with life and power.
She's had 10,000 origin stories.
Yes, but that's the best origin story.
I mean, at one point, she's literally just the daughter of Athena and Mars.
That's dumb. That's not a good origin story.
No.
Like, I don't even like the one where Zeus is her dad. No, I like the clay one.
She did seem really offended when Lex Luthor made the quip about Zeus. She's like...
Don't appropriate my culture, Jesse Eisenberg.
Of course, she's revealed in, like, a whole Greek-themed party at Lex Luthor's palace. Why not?
I don't know why Lex Luthor was having a Greek-themed party. It was not... That was not clear.
No.
Like...
He had a party exclusively so that Bruce Wayne could come break into his... the server farm that he keeps in his kitchen.
Yeah. Yeah, your classic kitchen server farm. As we all have.
Mercy's in this movie. It's not clear if she's a robot or not. I mean, who knows?
I don't know who that is, so I don't care.
It's Lex Luthor's robot bodyguard.
Yeah, you told me that. That still doesn't mean anything to me. I can't keep you in frame because I'm drunk.
You're not that drunk.
I'm a little drunk.
Turned into a lightweight in your old age.
Yep. I'm nearly 30, Chris.
Oh, God. No. Nearly 30. No way. Nearly 30.
Oh, you poor thing.
Oh, you're almost dead.
Get the burial plot now.
Just dig a hole. Crawl in.
I can feel the icy hand of death reaching for me.
That's just my right arm. Don't worry about it. poor circulation. I'm getting old.
Yep. You're my son from the future, and you've come to kill me.
They tried that in the last Terminator movie. It still sucked. This movie sucks. It's dumb.
It really sucks, yeah.
It's not even... like, Batman loves guns. There's one thing you have to know about Batman is he loves guns. He's got all of the guns. Bruce Wayne is clearly the president of the NRA. It's like, I deal with my trauma by reliving it on the range every day.
Yeah, also, the Wayne Manor has burned down at some indistinct point in the past. It's not clear when or why or how. That's just a thing that's in the movie. Wayne Manor is also set on the Yorkshire Moors from Wuthering Heights. Kate Bush is dancing on a cliff nearby, recreating the Wuthering Heights video. I got nothing else. That's the extent of my Wuthering Heights jokes.
This movie is dumb, bum, bum, bum. This movie is dumb, bum. This movie is dumb. Bum, bum, bum. This movie is dumb. It's dumb. It's a rock. If you want to beat your head against it, more power to you. They go back to the Kryptonian baby chamber and they give...
Oh, yeah.
They give birth to...
I don't think there are any more babies in the baby chamber.
Well, they dump Zod's body in there.
Yeah, and then Jesse Eisenberg puts his blood in there with Zod's body. And then makes a monster.
Just knowing Zack Snyder, I guarantee you they're like the first draft of the script. They're like, wait, he jacks off into the pool? Yeah, how else are you going to get your DNA in there? Well, what if it's just blood? That doesn't make any sense. No, no, no. A man's virility comes from his jizz.
It's true.
I hate Zack Snyder, if that's not clear.
Fuck him.
His objectivism is just all over this thing. Yeah. He has such a boner for Superman.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. Oh, yeah. He gets to direct the Ubermensch. Like, he could not be more happy.
Yeah, there's like a lot of Nazi symbolism in this movie. It's real uncomfortable.
Oh, what I was saying earlier about why I have no sympathy for Warner Brothers and all this panic that they're going through. And, how did we know this is going to happen? Warner Brothers produced and distributed Sucker Punch.
Yep.
He started this shit owing them like $60 million.
Yep.
What, and then like everything that he did wrong with Sucker Punch, he has just carried forward to the, okay, that's not entirely fair. Sucker Punch is a much worse movie than this. Don't.
I've never actually successfully watched Sucker Punch.
Let's not do that.
We've already decided against Suicide Squad. We've decided to not do that to ourselves. Let's not do Sucker Punch.
It's like Vanessa Hudgens is in it, yes, but it's not enough.
Yeah.
What
a weird, weird world we live in now that, like, Vanessa Hudgens is now a plus. I'm real happy for her.
She's long been a plus for some of us. But
gross.
Yes, because you find her completely unattractive.
No, I'm not saying that. You stop laughing at me, Meg.
What? No.
But yeah.
I'm not on trial here.
Oh, yeah, I've never seen you have a more visceral physical reaction to a character than the female Kryptonian lieutenant in Man of Steel.
That's true.
The whole movie is terrible, but the minute she shows up, you're just like, yep. Oh, hello.
Yep.
That was... It's like, you were like drunk, half passed out on the couch, and you're just like, I am re-engaged with this narrative.
Look, all I want from a girl is a girl who I look at her and I immediately know that she could beat me up. Like, I don't want her to beat me up. I just like knowing that she could.
I think we all know why you secretly love Breaking Dawn Part 2.
That's not a secret.
It just combined the two things you want most in life.
Oh, Kristen Stewart and a girl who can beat me up?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh. Well, this video has taken a turn.
Because it's better than this fucking movie.
God, this movie is so bad.
It's real bad.
Yeah. I like, it's not as bad as Man of Steel.
And thankfully,
I would like to hammer that in.
And thankfully, yes. Superman is dead and he'll never come back because no. Superman fought...
he's gone forever.
Doomsday, and he's dead now, and he's gone forever. That's how it works, right? You can't come back from the dead.
Yeah. I would like to say, I believe that it is Doomsday because Chris told me it is. Like, that is never established within the movie.
He starts out very squishy, and then every time he keeps, like, molting and getting more rock-like.
At one point, he bears a striking resemblance to the shit monster from Dogma.
Yes. And then he turns into the cave trolls from Lord of the Rings.
Yes.
And then he kind of, like, does a swamp thing for a while. And then yeah. he gets a boner. Like, out of everywhere.
Yes. Out of all of the protruding bits. There's more protruding bits.
Yep. And
this is a very phallic movie.
Yes, it's Zack Snyder.
I mean, yeah.
Every movie he makes is just a
it's a love letter to dicks.
It's a cry to the universe, and it's like, my dick is giant and hard. Only a virile male can bring you this. Cower before me, betas. I shot my voice.
Yep.
Anyway, you want to take us out? Because I can't talk anymore.
Did you seriously kill your voice?
Getting very close.
Okay. So that's the end of that. Man of Steel sucks.
It does.
This movie sucks too.
It does.
I did periodically just forget, like momentarily just forget what movie we watched. It's fine. I don't recommend watching it. Like, even as a curiosity, it's, like, not, like, particularly satisfying. Like, it's just not worth it.
Nope.
No. Hopefully Wonder Woman is good. I mean, she was the only character I cared about going in to the DC Cinematic Universe. And is probably going to be the only character I care about going forward.
If you want to see... if you want to see Justice League... Wonder Woman showed up and is cool and is hanging out with bats.
Mm-hmm.
And Superman's dead.
That's pretty much it.
Yeah.
That's all you need to know going in.
Yep.
Like, there's some stuff with, like, The Flash and Aquaman and Cyborg, and that's, like... Yep.
They're there. They're out there somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Like, a solid half hour of this movie was just devoted to setting up Justice League.
Yeah, but that was only 5% of it. So,
I know. Yeah,
this movie's unconscionably long.
It's real bad.
Unconscionably long.
So long.
And Megan, what'd you think of it?
Meh.
Like, that's it? Just meh?
That's fair.
It took us 25 minutes to say that. I know. So.
Meg's succinct in a way that we're not. Is that everything?
I think so.
I mean, there's just not that much to talk about here. I thought this would produce, like, a more substantial episode of the show, but it's just...
Like, stay tuned, because I'm going to try to get her to watch at least the first episode of Iron Fist, because it's the worst.
I don't want to. I believe it's the worst. I believe you. I believe you. I don't need to see for myself.
But it's like Disney paid a community theater group to, like, do their best over an afternoon, and this, and then it turned in. It's so bad. I didn't want to watch this.
This was less racist
than Iron Fist. Against humans. I mean, I feel like its treatment of Kryptonian...
Kryptonian lives matter.
Green lives matter.
No, I think that's it. I don't think there's really anything else to say.
No.
It's just not very good.
No.
Like, it's not even fun bad, it's just bad bad.
Nope, it's a big pile of Snyder.
Yep.
The big, steaming, stinking pile of Snyder. Like, if... Hitting a tire with a hammer is a pretty apt metaphor for this movie, actually.
The more you say hitting a tire with a hammer, the more it sounds like a masturbation euphemism to me.
Oh, that just hurt. I don't even know what that means. It just sounds awful.
Yeah. Just gotta hit that tire with a hammer.
Is it like a euphemism for like unlubricated anal sex? Like, I don't... God. I don't...
No, I said masturbation. I don't know
what... Right, but I don't think you understand how masturbation works.
I can assure you that I do.
I just... I'm terrified that you look at somebody... Like, you look at a giant muscular person hitting a tire with a hammer, and you're like, oh, yeah, yeah, I've been there, brother. Sometimes you're just trying to sleep, and you're just like, you gotta get that hammer out.
There are a lot of very powerful vibrators on the market, Christopher. I don't know what to tell you. Okay. That's the end of this video. Jesus Christ. This one really got away from me.
I'm loving it.
I know you are, because you're disgusting.
Hey, you're the... I don't know what's up with that hammer, but...
Do you have anything else?
Nope.
Okay.
So, it sucks. Don't watch it.
Yeah.
If you watch it, it'll destroy your voice.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's from watching 2.5 hours of Batfleck go, murder! Mm-hmm. Oh, God.
So we're going to stop recording, and we're going to get Chris some hot water with lemon. We're going to prepare him as much as we can.
So, have a good time. Yep. Don't watch this movie.
I know. We don't have a sign-off for this show.
Nope. Just, if you want to have a good time, avoid this movie and just go hammer your tire.
That's it. Yep. We did it. Hooray.
Bye.